Hello guys, in this video I'm basically going to introduce the MATLAB. I'm using MATLAB 2016A version in Windows. So what I'm going to do today is I'll introduce MATLAB to you. I will tell you what all these windows mean, actually the command window, the editor, the workspace. Also in my upcoming videos I'm going to use MATLAB and demonstrate how we can use image processing with MATLAB. So basically I'm going to carry out simple image processing tasks with MATLAB, so that will give you a better understanding of image processing, and also you will learn MATLAB, which is a wonderful thing. MATLAB is one of the best softwares. So let's get started. So let me first introduce you to the different windows. So this is the command window. So basically here you can type anything that you want. Say I want a variable x and its value should be say 5. So here you can see I've put x is equal to 5. So it has stored a variable name x and the value is 5. So workspace basically tells you the information about the different variables that you are using in your program and its corresponding value. Okay, so now this was a basic integer variable. Suppose I want to create an array. So let's use some other variable, say y. So I can create an array as 1, 2, 3, 4 just by giving spaces. So I've just given space in between, and when I press enter, so you can see in the workspace I have my y created with an array of 1 2 3 4. These are the elements. Also the interesting thing is you can double click on this variable and see that here there is an Excel type of sheet that is been opened, and here you can see the different values of y. Another interesting thing is you can also change these values. I can put this 6 and it will store the value 6. Here you can see the value has changed. So you can also change the values over here manually by typing into it if you want. You can always look over here and see what your variable is consisting of. So what values are these? You can always see over here. So this is just by clicking the particular variable and you get, see now x had only one value, so it has only one value over here. Also suppose you want to create a 2D array, suppose. So for 2D arrays I will type x equals, say consider something else, say z. So z equals 1 2 3. So this is the first row basically. When I put a semicolon, you go into the second row. So now you can have 3, 4, 5 with spaces. Spaces are very important. So here you can see I have created a 2D array. So you can see when I click Z, I get a 2D array with second row. Initially I used to get only one row. So now I have a second row over here. Also you can change these values also if you want, and then that will get stored accordingly. So this is all about the command window. Also if you type clc, now these are so many commands that I have already typed and these I don't want it now. So I type clc. Clc stands for clear console. So when I do clear console and hit enter, my command window will get cleared. So now suppose I am working on a different program. So I don't want these variables now, because suppose let us consider that these variables were from this program. But now I am opening a different program, so I don't need these variables. Or else if the same name is used in this program also, then what will happen is these variables will provide some garbage value. So you always have to make sure that before writing your program you have your workspace cleared. So for that the command is clear. So you see when I use clear, I have cleared my workspace. Now there is no variable in the workspace. So that is what clear does. Also, suppose consider a variable say x. Also remember, when I'm making an array, I'm using the square brackets. The square brackets and the round brackets have a lot of difference. So in MATLAB, a square bracket and a round bracket means a lot different. So for every time a matrix uses a square matrix as a square bracket, a matrix uses a square bracket. So I'll type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 suppose. So this is my array x. Now suppose I want to plot this on the graph. Say I want to plot x. So the command is simply plot x. Notice I use round brackets over here. Always remember, when I'm using a function, now plot is a function, a predefined MATLAB function. So when I'm using a function, at that time I'll use round brackets. And when I want to create an array, so now this is something that I'm creating, that is an array. So for array I use square brackets, and for functions I use round brackets. That is the thing that you should always remember. So here you can see I have plotted my x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 over here. So what it does basically, on the x axis it has, yeah, so here you can see on the x axis it has these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is the array numbers. So this 1 corresponds to this, 2 corresponds to this, and the y axis has the numbers for x. Similarly, suppose I have y is equal to say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. When I plot y, so here you can see at 1 the value is 2, at 2 the value is 4. So this x-axis is nothing but the array numbers, and the y-axis is nothing but the corresponding values of the array. So at first place I have 2, at second 2 I have 4, and accordingly. Also, if suppose I want a discrete plot, I will use stem. So if I do stem y, I will get a discrete plot. So here you can see this is a discrete plot. At 1 the value is 2, at 2 the value is 4, at 3 the value is 6, and so on. So this was all about when I am plotting only one variable, that is y. You can also do plot x comma y. So plot x comma y will plot x values on the x axis and y values on the y axis. That's it. Similarly, you can do stem x comma y. So it will plot the x axis on the x values on the x axis and y values on the y axis. Also notice, suppose I minimized the figure and now I want to plot something, say I am plotting x. You notice that the command has been executed, but you feel that nothing has appeared, nothing has been done. So I type plot x again and you feel nothing is happening. Where is the plot gone? So always remember, whenever this thing happens, there is a window that is opened down, so the graph has been plotted over there. So always remember, if such a thing you are plotting and that plot is not appearing on the screen, that means that window is open down. So you will have to go here and then you'll have to click and then you get the. So always remember, whenever a figure is open and you do some operation, that is a graph operation like stem x or stem y, that graph has been overwritten in the same figure window. So always remember this. If this is minimized, then whatever instruction you type, it will not appear in the graph window unless you open the graph window. So that is important to know. Also, if suppose you there are many graphs or many windows such are open, then for that, and you if you want to close these windows, so for that the command is close. So when you close, all the windows will get, only the MATLAB window will remain open and all other windows except this window will close. So yeah, that was all about the basics of MATLAB. Also remember one more thing, these are the variables, these are the different programs that I have written. So when you want a step by step, that is execution while you are writing the program, you use the command window. But if you want to write the program at once and then execute it, for that we use the script. So what is script? You go to new, you go to script, and you get a new blank script. We always make it a habit to start the script with CLC so that it will clear the console, if any clear, so that it will clear the workspace, and close so that it will close any windows that is open before the program has been run. So let us save this program and run and see what happens. So let me save this, or else you can directly run, it will ask you to save. A window has been open, it is telling me to save. Say consider I save it on my desktop. See, you can see the command window has been cleared, the workspace has been cleared, and I did not have any window open, so that is almost clear. So that is also clear. So yeah, next you can type your program over here. X is equal to 0, say a simple program. Y is equal to, say make y a array. For array I use a square bracket, 1, 2, 3, 4 suppose. And in MATLAB you put semicolon, you don't put semicolon, it does not make a difference. So it is okay if you want to put or don't, or you don't put, it is no problem actually. So here you can see that the variables have been created and the program has been executed. Let me tell you the significance of semicolon over here. Suppose I put a semicolon and I run the program, you can see that nothing has been displayed. So the purpose of semicolon is to basically display a value on the command window. If you want to display what values my variable have, then you don't put a semicolon and it will display. But when you write big programs, you will be very much irritated if all the variables are displayed on the command window. Hence we have a practice of putting the semicolon, and hence all the command, there will be nothing displayed on the command window, and then you can work on your program. So this was a basic introduction to MATLAB. On my upcoming videos, I'm going to share basic image processing with MATLAB. So please be tuned to my channel, and please subscribe to my channel so that you get notified about my new uploads and you can learn MATLAB with image processing. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.